I'm confused why we're here. The project we have been offered seems to be in the early stages of negotiations. Your preposterous disregard for meticulous zoning type parameters as a tactical performance of haggling in order to achieve the ulterior motive of putting luxury housing where it simply does not make sense. I am tired of our performance of desperation. It is not 2009 anymore. We need to hold ourselves to a standard higher than 600 feet. About a week ago, Providence Business News published an article listing our city as the sixth worst in the world for student housing in the world. I was a full-time student working multiple jobs up to 38 hours a week to make my $575 a month tenure. Things only got worse when my family's home of 23 years was foreclosed, losing everything, and I had to keep up with my risky peers and international applicants influencing our local housing stock. We've been offered luxury housing before, a place where these elite alumni to stay post-grad, fantasizing that they'll spend their humble fortunes in our city. The water place towers took years to fill, and by the end of it, the units were going for 50 cents on the dollar. We were sold the Providence Place Mall and promised that luxury retailers would provide the opportunity for these transplants to dispose their disposable income, and yet today every floor has an empty storefront. When are we going to think long-term? The reason why the I-95 plan is open in the first place is because a few decades later, we turned around and said, huh, maybe that's not a good place for a highway, with no apology for the thriving Cape Verdean and Portuguese communities we scattered, busting a valuable cultural identity. City councilors, please do not repeat our same mistakes. Stand up for your people, the people that are already here and struggling, the people that voted for you to defend our best interests, to create a legacy of wisdom, reflective, and discerning judgment. We need jobs, we deserve jobs, we deserve jobs, not just for unions, and we deserve projects that both put my generation to work and not further our housing divide opportunity. This cannot be too much to ask. Raise the standard. We do not have a market for luxury at this scale. That is a historical fact. We have a market for affordability. We are actively in a housing crisis. I am speaking as an individual personally affected.